Hi, I'm Dylan with Mastercam, and in this video, I'd like to show you a few ways to utilize wireframe to drive your tool axis control in multi-axis toolpaths. I need to cut the recessed surfaces on the underside of this part. I already have a morph toolpath created, and I'm happy with the cut pattern on the surface of the part, but I haven't configured my tool axis control or collision control. If I look at the tool motion in backplot, I can see that the holder comes in contact with the part, which would result in a crash in the machine. The first thing I need to do is decide how the axis of the tool is oriented to the surface of the part, and I'll do this with the tool axis controls. I'll start by switching the strategy to From Point and selecting this wireframe point that's out away from the part. The best way to think about how the From Point strategy is going to affect the toolpath is to imagine the shank of the tool being extended out to the point you've selected, and then all toolpath motion occurring with the theoretical end of that tool staying at that point in space. If I regenerate the toolpath and look at the tool motion in backplot, I can see that the holder no longer contacts the part, so I don't need to enable collision control. When programming 5-axis toolpaths, there will be times when you will need to use collision control together with tool axis control in order to avoid a collision. However, it's always best practice to start with your collision control off and take the time to find a tool axis control strategy that provides as clean a toolpath as possible. This workflow will generally provide a better surface finish and smoother machine motion while cutting. If you rely on collision control to make up for a poorly chosen tool axis control strategy, you can end up with a toolpath that has a lot of abrupt movements that can affect the surface finish and can slow down the machine, making cycle times longer. Looking closely at my toolpath again in backplot, I can see that although there are no collisions, the tool does come close to what would be a plunge move in this area, which I don't want. I'm going to change my control strategy slightly to address this. I've created this wireframe line along the center line of the feature. I'll change my tool axis control strategy to From Chain, select the line as my geometry, and make sure my curve tilt type is set to From Start to End for each contour. This strategy is similar to From Point in the fact that the rear of the tool stays pointed at the geometry I selected for control. But the addition of From Start to End for each contour means that the axis of the tool will move along the line as it cuts the surface. The shorter the line, the greater the tool will tilt. The longer the line, the less the tool will tilt. I can use splines as well for more complex surfaces. The resulting toolpath is smooth, and the tool contact point is more consistent. But I'm still not happy with the angle of the tool to the part surface. As we saw a moment ago, since the length of my line affects the tilt of my tool, I can simply shorten my line slightly and then regenerate the toolpath to have the tool tilt sooner along the pass. Using wireframe geometry to control the tool motion is a very simple and effective 5-axis programming method, and it makes the toolpath's motion easy to predict and edit.